does not have lots of sugar in it because it's not good for you. So now at the beginning you eat sugar, your pancreas responds, no big deal. Upregulation, it brings more insulin, more receptors. But you know, when you keep pounding on the sugar all the time, all you eat is carbohydrates. What will happen then, the affinity of your receptors will no longer react to the sugar that you have like it used to. I'm so happy to see you, sugar. Now no more the receptors are happy. I've seen you all day now. I don't like you anymore. So now your body down regulates your receptors, and therefore now your sugar, your carbohydrates will remain in your blood. That will cause hyperglycemia, which will make you diabetic. Congratulations. Why? Well, you keep eating sugar. What am I saying that for? One of our shaykh, Sheikh Al-Fattah Abu Ghudda rahimahullah, used to say, كَثْرَةُ الْمَسَاسِ تُقَلِّلُ الْإِحْسَاسِ. Lots of everyday sensitivity, you'll be desensitized. Desensitized. Why? Well, now this beauty that you always thought, and what happens, and I would like to tell you this, brothers and sisters, usually when people have an imagination of a perfect picture, they only have of that love the picture. The rest of their love that they imagine, they fill in the blanks. They only have the picture. They don't know what she's all about. She doesn't know what he's all about. All she sees is the picture. But what about the rest? She fills her imagination. The perfection that she has, or the perfection that he has, is all filled like this. And then they go. And then soon, sometimes they are surprised. Surprised by what? When you live with people every single day, well, you see things and you become sensitive. You have good days, you have bad days. You argue, you know, it's not like always you forgive and forget. Because life is up and down like this. Furthermore, that person was enslaved to the external looks, to the beauty, supposedly, whatever that beauty is, that external looks. But you know, when he used to see her or she used to see him before, they used to see each other on the best state. Huh? Very nicely dressed, all these things. But now he sees her when she wakes up, and he sees her when she's going to sleep, and when she's cooking, and when she's doing all these things. He doesn't see her in the best of state anymore. Yet he sees everybody else outside in the best of state, supposedly. Because he is enslaved to beauty, he sees now from that point on that she is no longer as beautiful as he thought she was, but someone else is. Desensitization, and now you're blind. You don't, because you see her in every position, but you don't see everyone else in every state and situation. You see them always in supposedly the best looking states. Love? I don't think so. Let me tell you this story, and I don't like to tell stories usually, but it's okay just to get off a little bit, get off of that seriousness look that you all have on your face. Sallu ala Rasulullah wa ala. There's a young female. Someone was following her from those people on the streets. She's a decent girl, educated, family educated her, raised her well. He's following her everywhere she goes. Yahi, why are you following me? I love you. Right off the bat like this, huh? All of a sudden becomes poetic. And that person goes to the masjid and pray, Allahu Akbar. Oh Allah, please, please give me that woman. Now all the prayer becomes about her. But all he saw from her is her external looks, like the other one. Now they're deluded that happiness is only with her, or happiness is only with him. Anyone else? No, no way. What? External looks was the anchor. Why are you following me? I love you. All the time I love you. Biggest lie in the world, usually. If it's unfounded rightly. He kept bothering her day after day, and every time she asked him, why are you following me? He says, I love you. And then one time he was close to her, he says, why are you following me? She says, I love you. She said, no, look. He says, why do you love me? She says, because you're so beautiful. She said, look over there, my sister is more beautiful than me. He looked over there, she said, you're a liar. Had you loved me, you wouldn't be looking at my sister. There was no sister. Had you really loved me, why would you be looking at someone else? Huh? She's more beautiful than me. There you go, gotcha. Therefore, that beauty will fade. Depending on that external looks, that will fade. That will fade. There are other people who are not enslaved to beauty, but they're enslaved to money, status, social status, money. He wants to marry someone of this family, of this place, of this kind of education. She has to have triple PhDs, 2 masters, and 5 bachelors. Fulfilling an inferiority complex. I'm trying to talk to you so we can get to the bottom of things. Because the brothers told me what they actually said. Said, Sheikh, please do not just come and give us perfect examples from the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We want you to be real. Though I think that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's example are very, very real, and I will come to them anyway. But I'm trying to be, quote unquote, a little bit real, supposedly. So these people are the hostage. I call them the hostage. Asir. The hostage for money. He wants her family to be rich, wealthy. So he will be, actually he will dress, he will make himself up on that, you know, on that level. I'm that socioeconomic level. You know, besides, you know, we always live like that. You know, we're all, you are a human being. Kullukum li Adam wa Adamu min turab. You're all from Adam. And Adam is from turab. Adam is from clay. Adam alayhi salam is from clay, and all of us from Adam. What makes you different than the other? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna akramakum inda Allah atqakum. These people, they call being hostage to money or position or external looks, all these things, they call them love. هذا من باب تسمية الأشياء بغير مسمياتها. They call things names that are not really necessarily reflective of what it is. Versus you see, when we take the example of Musa alayhi salam and the daughters of Shu'aib. قَالَ مَا خَطْبُكُمَا الْقُرْآنِ الْكَرِيمِ. And I don't want to go into the story, is very long. Some other time, inshallah, we'll go talk about the tafsir of these ayahs. But Musa alayhi salam, he sees them. He sees two women, two young ladies, the daughters of Shu'aib alayhi salam. Their father is extremely old, and they are waiting for the shepherds to go so they can fill the water and they can take water. And Sayyidina Musa, he asked them one word. Not, you know, open-ended questions and all these things. مَا خَطْبُكُمَا. What is your story? Why are you waiting? And they tell him why. Then after that, Quran says, tells us, فَجَاءَتْ أَحْدَاهُمْ وَتَمْشِي عَلَى اسْتِحْيَاءٍ. One of them came walking with in shyness. Even the walk, the way you walk, dear sisters, and the way you walk, dear brothers, the non-verbal communication that you always give, the vibes that you produce, all that you shall be accounted for. Pinch yourself. Just like it hurts you, it hurts everybody else. But Al-Quran talks about the daughter of Shu'aib alayhi salam, تمشي على استحياء. She's walking with in shyness. Iman covering her. Al-Iman covers you. What does she tell him? Why don't you call me at home tonight? We will talk after midnight when everyone is asleep. Or now the text messaging. Right? The bill comes $300 because of all the text messaging. And now we have all these communications and new phones and all these communications. Now, all these things. Is this what she told him? Or she told him, why don't we do this? Why don't we go out and hang out? You know, go out, hang out a little bit, just to chat, you know. Nothing, alhamdulillah, we're not, alhamdulillah, we will observe everything, you know. What did she tell him? Inna abi yad'uk. I'm not calling you to my house. My father is the one who's calling you. What does she tell her father? She gives him a hint. Ya abati istajir. Oh father, hire this man. That Musa, he looks, he's a nice young man. إِنَّ خَيْرَ مَنِ اسْتَأْجَرَ.